it's Hannah, and today I'm going to show you how to make this really cute flag peyote stitch pendant. It is super easy to make. You can either make it with a pointed top or you can make it flat like I have here. I'm just going to pop an eye pin through when I found my round nose pliers, but at the moment I can't locate them. These flag pendants are really easy to make and they're super cute. You can do any design that you like. I stuck with a simple chevron because that is how I roll. I do go through how to do the stitch in this tutorial, so you don't need to go anywhere else except to watch this. And with all that being said, let's just get on with it, shall we? So you are going to need these beads. I don't know how many of each, all depends on how long your flag is. You're also going to need a size 10 beading needle. So to start with, we are going to pick up one grey, two green, two silver, three grey, two silver, two green, and one grey. The reason it took me so long to do this in the clip is because I was reading the pattern and I was just getting very confused. I'm not used to reading peyote patterns, especially starting a chevron. It's very confusing for those of you who have tried it before. It's ridiculously confusing, but I picked them all up. Eventually I worked it out and here it is. Very nice. We're then going to slide that down our thread. Then we are going to pick up a green bead and then go through that first green bead in the row. So we are skipping the first grey bead and going through the green bead, which is the second bead in the row. Then we are picking up a silver bead, skipping that bead and going through the silver bead. So we're skipping that next green bead and going through the silver one. Then we're picking up a grey bead, skipping the next silver bead and going through the next grey bead. Wonderful. See, it's starting to stack up nicely. Now we're going to pick up another grey bead. Oh no, a green bead, sorry. And we are going to go through the next grey bead. That's what I meant to say. Making sure you're keeping your work nice and tight. Then we're going to pick up another grey bead and go through that next silver bead. So each time we are skipping a bead and then going through the next one. Does that make sense? Yeah. So then we're picking up another silver bead and we're skipping that next green one and going through the one after and also going through the grey bead. Wonderful stuff. Then we're picking up a green bead. Then we're going to go down diagonally through those two green beads you can see. Like so. So you've got three green beads in a row. And pull that nice and tight and get your fingers all tangled in it and all sorts of fun stuff that comes with peyote. Try to straighten your beads out, sort your life out. Then we're going to go through that silver bead, that green bead, and then that bottom grey bead. Yep, come on Hannah, speed it up. Here we go. And then we're going to go through that green bead. Grand. Now we're ready to start row three. So you're going to pick up one silver bead and then go through the bead that's sticking up. Now it's easy, you're filling in the gaps. I'm not going to tell you what bead to go through. You're picking up a grey bead now. I realised only as I was editing this that it wasn't the best filming I've ever done. Pick up a green bead, sorry. So in a lot of the shots, I realise I'm right at the bottom of the camera. Another green bead. And I shall tell you for why. I decided far too last minute that I wanted to make this video. One grey bead, sorry. Oh, my arm. Come on, get a grip, Hannah. I decided far too late that I wanted to make this video, so I didn't really have enough practice time and enough time to work it all out. So it was very close to my, well, very close to my face, basically. I'm not very comfortable with peyote. Pick up a silver bead. You see the chevron pan starting to fall. And so I just was concentrating on it too much and I wasn't looking at the camera enough. And if you can't pick it up and you can't make sense out of the tutorial that I've spliced together, let me know and I will try and do my best to refilm it. Sorry, green bead. I've stopped listing the beads. They're on the screen. One silver bead. I'll go back to do my job now. Sorry. or one green bead. Did you all have a nice new year? One grey bead. Had a nice new year. Came to Nottingham. Stayed with my sister, that's where I currently am. Oh, we're going to do that wiggly bit at the end like we did last time. And then picking up a silver bead, and then you're going to go through those two silver beads. See? There we go. Yeah, you can see what I'm doing. Came to Nottingham because my sister's living there, and met up with some of my friends who I used to work with at the bead shop. That was grand. And then we just had a quiet night in because we're old now. Too old for a night out on the lash. Then you continue the pattern, which there will be a link to in the description box below, as per usual. Now we're creating the two points on either sides to put your jump rings through. So you pick up a green, and then you pick up a silver. Wonderful. Then you pick up a grey. Then you need to wiggle back round through your beadwork till you're coming out of that bead you've just attached, facing back towards yourself. So I go through the bead underneath the one we're coming out of, and then the one diagonally down to that. You can see. But that's my go-to trick. It's not even a trick, it's just method. And then back through the silver directly above it. And then back towards myself. And then I can start the next row, which will be a grey bead. Wonderful, and then a silver bead. And then we need to do a similar kind of thing. Do we? No, we don't need to do a similar kind of thing on this side. I am talking rubbish. Now we're going to pick up another silver bead. And then another grey bead after that. Just gradually decreasing, you know, as you do. Do the wiggly thing. Wiggle through beads to come out facing the other way. See? I know what I mean. You know what I mean. But yeah, let me know what your New Year's resolutions are. I think I might make a video at some point explaining my New Year's resolutions. But as you're watching this, oh, pick up another grey bead, sorry. As you're watching this, oh, one more grey bead. I'll get to explaining what I want to explain. So that is one point done. So now we want to go through the beads until we come out of that one here. So the way I find it easiest is to literally just go through all the grey beads. They're all in a line anyway. So you're just making your life that little bit easier. Just make sure that top bead's straightened up. And see, now you're coming out of the right bead. So now just continue the pattern as you did the other side by starting to pick up a grey bead and a silver bead. Then it's odd count peyote, so you're going to have to go through the green and the grey bead and then wiggle back through. You know, like you have done for the rest of the small flag so far. But yes, as I was saying, when you are watching this, I will be on a plane, I hope. On the way to Amsterdam. So Mario and I are going to continue the pattern following the beads on the screen. Sorry, as in the colours I've turned. Anyway, Mario and I are going to Amsterdam, so that's very exciting. Going to Amsterdam and then Brussels and then Cologne only for the day Cologne, because we don't live that far from it, so we can always just get the train up for a weekend or something. And then back to Frankfurt. So that's my week. So if I'm not very present on social media and you see a lot of Instagram posts, now you know why. Very nice. So now picking up a grey bead, and then we're wiggling through again, picking up a silver bead, and we're wiggling through again. You've got this. You've got this pattern down. Most of you probably just looked at the printed pattern and thought, Hannah, I got this. I got this. I don't mind the fact that you're waffling over the top of the whole tutorial because I actually know what you're doing. which is very comforting to me. Wonderful. One grey. Sew through there, wiggle through again. I can't think of any song that's got the word wiggle in. Oh, there's got to be one. It's probably something about a worm. Oh, there was a worm at the bottom of my garden, and his name is Wiggly Woo. That's a song. Like, it's a kid's song, obviously. Which is obviously how I know it. You don't care. Pick up the... Oh yeah, go through that one as well. Go through the silver one. Pick up your grey bead. Go back. And then... Ooh! We're going to sew through our beads until we come out of that bottom grey one. I just stuck my needle through there. The one that the tail's coming out of. Because then we're starting to decrease down there. So I'm just going to sew up and down and up and down and up and down all of those beads around the edge. Be very careful that you don't split your bead. I cannot say this enough. If your needle won't go through, switch to a smaller, thinner needle. Take a different route. You cannot fit a massive lorry down a tiny country lane. So don't think you can do the same with a needle that have got a little thread in it, because it will just break. So now we're going to continue the chevron pattern, but the other way around. So we're going to start with a grey, and then a green, and then a silver. And then another silver. I said that in a really obnoxious way, I'm sorry. Then another green. And a grey. And then now we've got to wiggle back through the beads, so we come out of the bead we've just attached, facing towards us, because we're decreasing. We want a nice point on this. But yeah, just continue the pattern. So grey and then green. You can see the pattern by now, which is quite good. It's just the first couple of rows I personally find super confusing. If there's anyone who doesn't find it confusing and would like to explain to me how to stop finding it confusing, that would be really helpful. And don't just tell me to read the pattern, because I know I should. I do just read the pattern. You can't fob me off that easily. Wiggle through the beads, wiggle, wiggle, wiggle through the beads, wiggle, wiggle, wiggling, wiggle, wiggle, wiggling, wiggling. Continue to decrease, following the chevron pattern. Nice. Good speeding up there. But yeah, sorry for that terrible song I just wrote about wiggling. Because, yeah, you can tell that I'm not going to be coming out with a CD anytime soon. Not of my own original work, anyway. Had a good time singing Christmas carols at Christmas, though. Man in church sat next to me on Christmas Day, was very impressed, told me that I should be in the choir. What can I say? So now we are going to sew back through our work, finishing off our thread, making sure that we are following the pattern of the bead so you don't just get a random bit of thread sticking out somewhere. Then this is a 4mm silver plated jump ring. I'm twisting that open because that is how we open jump rings in life. If you pull them apart, it's impossible to get them nice and flush next to each other. So twisting it open, popping it through that top bead, popping it on a chain, twist it back closed. Twist. Wonderful. Grand. And then repeat the same with the other point. Twist. A list of all materials and where I got them from can be found in the description box below. So don't forget to check that out before you ask me where I get my supplies from. It's always down there, so have a look. Ta-da! Yeah! Now you know how easy it is to make one of these pendants of your very own. I'm excited to see all the wonderful colour combinations that you come up with, because I'm sure you will come up with some amazing ones. If you did enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to give it a big old thumbs up. Your support, like I always say, it truly does mean the world to me, and why not hit subscribe? I post new craft tutorial here in the Corner of Craft every Sunday, and I sometimes post a bonus video in the week as well. So I would love it if you stuck around and join the party in the Corner of Craft. We have a lot of fun. If you do decide to recreate something using one of my tutorials, I would love to see a picture of it, so please feel free to post a picture on social media using the hashtag #thecornerofcraft so I can check it out, see how talented you all are, and like I say, I want to see the colour combinations that you come up with. Don't forget to check out the description box below for a list of all the materials that I used to make this pendant, as well as where I got them from. I think that's everything I have to say. Hopefully. Thank you very much once again for watching, and I shall see you very soon in my next video. Bye! It's Hannah, and today I'm in a slightly different location. This is my childhood bedroom. How exciting!